session, first I will try to explain what is valleytronics. Then in next slide, in next future slides, I will try to how we can control the valley and what are the application. First, the definition. Valleytronics is made of two words. One is valley and another one is tronics. Here valley refers to the minima. In mathematics, minima is a curve which has a downward like structure. So valley refers to the minima of energy, and tronics. Tronics refers to the electronics. When we fabricate any electronics device where we are controlling the valley of the electron in a valley of the electron, that is energy of the site, then when we are fabricating any device with controlling of this valley to encode the data as 0 and 1, then we are saying that we are doing a valleytronics. Means this is the definition. So here in definition you can see valley refers to the minimum of energy when electronics uses this additional degree of freedom to encode the data in binary state of high and low, that is 0 and 1, called valleytronics. Here I would like to focus light on degree of freedom. Suppose we are having a charge, it has various degree of freedom where we can store the data. So one is the degree of freedom that it has charge. Suppose we are using the property of charge, and suppose here 0 refers to the in not presence of charge, and 1 refers to the presence of charge. So in electronics we use the property of electron, that is charge. In spintronics we use the property that is spin of electron. So similarly in valleytronics we control the valley of that electron. To understand valleytronics in detail we have to understand few complex words. Here first one is Brillouin zone. The definition of Brillouin zone will be in mathematics and solid state physics, the first Brillouin zone is directly defined primitive cell in reciprocal space. In the same way, the previous statics is divided up into Wigner cells. In real statics, the reciprocal statics is better up into the Brillouin zones. Here I would like to, in my topic, I have to focus on this reciprocal space. Actually, the reciprocal space is in momentum space, where we study this valley of the electron. Then we have to discuss about band structure. Band structure, it is regarding energy of the electron. Suppose we have semiconductor device or semiconducting elements. So in semiconducting element we have a valence band and conduction band. Valence band refers to the outermost energy level of the electron. And the conduction band refers where it is a higher energy state. So these are related. I will go to the next slide. So here we can see this structure. This is related to the Brillouin zone. Here this 1, 2, 3, 4, this is 6. These all are the sides of Brillouin zone. These are the sides, and this one here is side of energy. Suppose here it is minus k and here it's k. I stated earlier in Brillouin zone there is a momentum space. So this k refers to a suppose k momentum, and here minus k refers to the minus k momentum. And here this is energy state and this is also energy state. This place and this, suppose this place and this place. This both the places have same value, same energy, but the property that is different is momentum. That is angular momentum. So when we are controlling this angular momentum to fabricate a device, this is called valleytronics. So I will read it. Existence of opposite angular momentum at different site of same energy of valley gives opportunity to control the angular momentum of system and code the information in valley. So our question will always arise, why we are referring this valleytronics. Actually, suppose we are having a page and we want to encode the data, and in the page we are having two sides. Suppose we are getting an additional 3D, suppose let's talk about 3D page. So earlier we are having the property that is charge, where we can fabricate electronics. We were having spin, where we are fabricating spintronics. So use of valley gives additional space where we can store the data. Suppose in our mobile there is 4GB RAM. So in future, if we are using this valley of state of the electron, then this 4GB RAM will be increased to around 8 times, because there will be lots of sites, 1, 2, 3, 4, it is a hexagonal, so we are having this 6 more sites where we can store the data. So it is not a number, it will depend on the situation, which crystalline structure we are using to fabricate. So the use will be, it can be used in quantum computers, where we are already using the qubit of the, where we are using qubit to generate 0 and 1. So Valleytronics is a branch where we are simply using angular momentum, we are controlling the angular momentum to fabricate device. So up to now I have concluded a basic idea. Valleytronics uses angular momentum of valley to get binary data 0 and 1 state, that is up state and low state, and electronics we already know, and spintronics we already know. So up to now you can ask some questions so that I can move to further slides. Very few questions.
What is the advantage of Valleytronics?
Actually I already stated that we already had 2 degree of freedom, that is charge, and other one is spin. So we are getting an additional degree of freedom, that is valley where we can store the data to fabricate any electronic device. Next.
In Valleytronics, we are controlling the momentum of the electron.
Okay.
How we control the momentum of the electron?
Okay, I will explain it next slide also. So in basic, actually we use optically active lights, circularly optically active lights. Actually, it is an experimental observation that the behavior of valley of electron is different in case of right circularly optically polarized and left circularly optically polarized. There is also, okay. So, when we are, this slide is basically on how we are controlling the valley of electron. Overall, the study of Valleytronics refers how we are controlling that angular momentum electron. So basically, if we want to control, there are some terms, that is, one is Brillouin zone, another one is inversion symmetry, another one is time reversal symmetry, and another one is Barry curvature. I have studied about Barry curvature in next slides, but I will here discuss about when there is a lack of inversion symmetry, but presence of time reversal symmetry. If we are controlling, actually there are two symmetries, inversion symmetry and time reversal symmetry. If absence of one is occurring, then only we can control the value of that electron. So this is a momentum space, and when this occurs, we are having, this is one energy state, this is another minima, this having same energy difference, this. But when we are applying magnetic field, so when we are applying magnetic field, we can control the spin. But we want to control the angular momentum of that electron. We want to control the angular momentum of that electron of the side. So we have to impose something where these two occur, the lack of inversion symmetry and the presence of time reversal symmetry. So with individually addressable valley in momentum space at k and k point in the first plane zone, this valley addressing opens the possibility of using the momentum state of electron, holes or excitant as a completely new paradigm in information processing. So here we are getting an additional degree of freedom by controlling the valley of electron because of presence of this lack of inversion symmetry and presence of time reversal symmetry. So here once again, this is the Brillouin zone, this is the 6th site. So now I am, how we are controlling, so it is experimental fact, circularly right polarized light excites minus k angular momentum, and vice versa, it is an experimental fact. There is lots of explanation what it occurs, but I am not going to discuss it. It's very complicated quantum mechanical phenomena. Here this is picture where this sketch is generating optical dichroism of K and minus K value in the T and DC monolayer. Actually this is a monolayer and this is a Brillouin zone. So once again here we can see at finally I want to conclude what is actually happening in the valleytronics. Here it's a Brillouin zone. Okay, this is six sides and here these all are sides in momentum space. Okay, so in 2s spaces of 2d transition metal, dichroism side type of inversion symmetry as a result exhibit contrasting Berry curvature and orbital magnetic moment between the K and K dash valley. If Berry curvature has different values at K and K dash point, one can expect different electron, hole, exciton behavior each valley as function of applied electric field. So here this Berry curvature is a mathematical property. It is very complex. But when there is occurrence of different values of Berry curvature, so at point K and K dash we accept different behavior of electron. So if we want to control that valley, so we have to pick the different behavior of that particular size. If want to control spin, so we have to mainly focus on magnetic moment. So we want to control the magnetic spin. By controlling the spin, we can control the magnetic moment with the help of magnetic field. So this. You can ask a questions also.
I still don't understand how you're controlling.